Greetings, Skylander. You have awakened us from our 10,000...
Now, I don't care about all that kind of stuff, but anyway, welcome back to more Skylander Spars Adventure, and as you probably might notice, my voice is a little bit different. Well, it's because I'm actually using a different recording setup. Even though I'm still using my phone to record, but I'm actually using a different app that can record the audio only, because I honestly really hated the fact that I had to record the video, but then have to downgrade it just to an MP3 file.
Its power could not be contained. You must prove your worth if you are to be trusted with the energy that flows through all things magic, the Quicksilver.
Okay, so we're gonna have a long, long way to get there. And I'm gonna try my best not to do the ums and ahs and all that kind of stuff, because it can sometimes get irritating, to be honest. So we're gonna use Prison Break just to begin with. Now, there's actually a few collectibles which are somewhat easy to get, but some of them are really, really difficult to get, not to mention locks. That's the one thing I really hated, is just, you know, moving the crystals, or no, not crystals, I meant the green goblin dude. And now we have some new enemies. They can actually shoot out some magic spears, which can actually, you know, deflect, as you might notice. And they do a lot of damage, so let's... Ow. Yeah, if you get hit, it will take a lot of damage to you, so let's do all this. I probably should have switched to a stronger Skylander, but what else can you do? Whoa, I'm leveled up. Okay, so next enemy is a Gnasher with a silent letter, I think. Now, the Gnashers, they're very similar to those fire dudes from the Vulcan Mole stage, but they have blue fire instead. Now, this puzzle is actually a little bit difficult. So we're gonna go left about four times. Two, three, four. And now we're gonna turn right about three times. Yeah, I'm actually using some notes from a book. We go left once. Whoops. And then we go right about seven times. Hopefully I don't miss this one. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And then we turn left two times, and then we turn right five times. Yeah, there was a strategy guide which is very, very useful for this. Wait a second, did I already screw this up? Oh no, I didn't. I'm supposed to go left two times. And there we go. And now we actually solved this puzzle. Now, this is a really difficult puzzle to get to, but if you actually wrote some notes, or if you have a... Damn it, I said again, which is really annoying. Anyway, you could either go and use the internet to look up some ideas, or you can use a strategy guide booklet. Now, this is the Archean Defender. Now, these guys are really, really tricky, because they'll actually have a shield, but once they're about to attack, they have a hammer, which is very, very powerful. Now, what's also really funny that I thought as a kid, that when they do their own hammer attack, once they slam it on the ground, it's like a guitar that is, like, slammed. I don't know, I actually thought of that as a kid, so we're going to get this beam on the crystal. Come on! Damn it, these crystals are such a pain. There's actually a special upgrade, which... you can turn enemies into crystals, which it can actually deflect, like lasers, which is very, very useful. So we're gonna put one, two, fire! And it seems to work, and I've leveled up. Let's get rid of this ball, kind of wrecks him. Okay, so after we've done that, we have a lot of experience points. That's very, very handy. There's actually going to be a second treasure chest, I think. But, whoa! I didn't actually see these enemies. I was looking at some notes here. Oopsie daisy. Yeah, slam the guitar at the floor. I always remember that as a kid, that their hammers look like guitars that they would play on the floor. It's... I don't know, it's just my weird imagination, pretty much. Let's put a crystal down and fire a laser at them. How dare you smash my crystals? I spent a lot of money making them. Fire. Come on. Do your attack. Oh, oh Jesus. Let's get rid of these guys because they are really, really annoying to get to. Okay, so after we've done that, we can now get to these guys. Come on. Do your thing. Yeah, leveled up just to get rid of them. So we went from level 1 to level 4, I think. And I probably should have switched to a faster Skylander because he is so slow. Come on. And we actually ate a cupcake. Yeah, I actually did a few heroic challenges. Okay, so here we actually have another... Yeah, don't worry, you won't get attacked because of this. Now, this one is actually very, very difficult as well, so we're gonna turn right about 3 times. And then we're gonna turn left once. And then we're gonna turn right about 6 times. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then we turn left once. And then we turn left about... right about 6 times. Oh, no, wait. Hold on, hold on, hold on. So we turn left once. And then turn right 3 times. I might have missed steps, but... you could just be creative on how you can get it. Oh, man. I'm not gonna say it's probably the easiest puzzle, but it is actually really difficult. I remember when I first did the puzzles, I really hated it because it was really annoying. Smash everybody! And that did not actually work. Alright, come on! Do your guitar slam. There we go. No guitar slamming for you. And sorry, I had to put a little bit of commie. Why did I say commie? I meant comedy. That's what I was supposed to say. Uh-oh. How did I miss that? Seriously. How did I miss this guy? Alright, do your thing. And now let me crystallize you, or demonetize. Which I think most YouTube content is now almost demonetizing a lot of videos, which... it kind of pissed a lot of people off, to be honest. And now we have the toughest enemy, the Archean Ultron. Yeah, the Archean Ultron. Now, he'll basically have a massive shield so that he can actually shoot some rockets at you, and then he has laser eyes too. So you want to dodge all this. Now, once the rockets are all gone, he will basically do the shield thing again. And now we have a soul gem of Wrecking Ball, which is the next Skylander we're going to do. An enemy slurp, which means he can eat some enemies, but only small ones. Now, he can also use it just... yeah, eat enemies as well as eat some collectibles and some food. It can sometimes be handy if they are hard to reach or if they're too far away. So, after we've done that, I think the next collectible we're getting is another treasure chest. Yeah, pretty much. Now, the next... I think the final Spellpunk is a Magic Spellpunk. Now, he'll basically use his magic trick inside the vase, and he'll basically just conduct a lightning at you, which it actually does very large damage. Now, the only gate in this place is a life gate, if I'm not mistaken. Wait, why are you smashing a treasure chest? What are you doing? I got some expensive cash in here. And, oh, we got invincibility frame, that's it. Use my invincibility frame power just to ignore these enemies. Oh, wait, hold on. Let's get that money. And, oh, I thought it was a teleporting thing. So, we got all the treasure chests. And, hold on. Okay, sorry about that. I was reading some notes because I felt like I was a little bit lost. But, anyway, the only collectibles we're missing is a hat and a legendary treasure for the life gate, and the last one is a scroll, I think. Okay. Oh, hold on. I didn't actually know that thing does increased damage. Well, yeah, you want to be careful with the magic spell point, because their attacks are really ridiculously, like, strong. Like, seriously. Let's get rid of this guy, and let me use my crystals, and just to dodge out of the way. Whoa! Oh no! Smash everybody! Kill everybody! Run! Running away! Yeah! I've already said it last time, but hey. Alright, let's get rid of this Ultron here. More like Megatron, more like Losertron, like every Tron in the whole game. Yeah, I had to put a bit of fun hits to it. Now, the life gate, I remember, it is actually a little bit trippy. What I mean by that is just some blocks, and the floor is basically a bit of a water illusion, pretty much. So I'm gonna use some roots just to grow a bridge. And let's keep going. So, dimensional rifts, that's gonna be somewhat interesting. Now, I haven't used camo in a very long time, so this is actually gonna be really interesting. All you have to do is just step on these blocks, and that's pretty much it. Now, there's actually gonna be a switch here, which is gonna be a little difficult to get. I wouldn't say it's easy, and I will honestly admit it, but yeah. If you step on that water, I think it will teleport you back to the life gate. I'm really not sure, but we'll actually give it a try to see what happens. Step on the switch and it will lower just one gate. That's not fair, I thought it's only some. Let's see what happens if I fall off. And wait, you don't fall off? That's odd, because I thought I remember you would fall off. That's how I remembered it when I was a kid. Oh, okay, that's incredibly strange. Alright, come on. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. I thought there was like an invisible wall that is preventing me from going on the moving block. Oh, that is the reason why. If you basically fall off from here, it will teleport you. So that is kind of helpful and sometimes bad at the same time, because it's not that bad, but it's a little annoying. Now we're gonna go across this direction, because I think in here is a legendary treasure. It's a hat. I thought it was a legendary treasure. Now stepping on that teleporter, I think, takes you to the very beginning of the life gate, if I'm not mistaken. So we got a unicorn hat. Oh, I just said it correctly. I just didn't know it would be exactly called a unicorn hat. I'll be right back once I get the other direction. I can see a really bizarre line underneath the water, as you can see right here. Ooh. I thought I actually fell off, but no, apparently just made it. And now we have some roller skates. Oh, I just said it again. That's very ironic. I just said roller skates, and then it exactly says roller skates. Now, let's see what that teleporter takes us to. I'm kind of convinced it will take us to the beginning of the life gate. Let's see. And I was right. It takes you to the beginning of the life gate. Okay, so we open this gate, and in here we're gonna do a few moving blocks, and basically, it's a crystal and beam kind of puzzle.
Discovering our secrets. Beyond this gate is what remains of our defenses.
Alright, so basically we need to get the Quicksilver, which is basically protected by these three beams.
The Quicksilver vault lies ahead. It will only open when the three energy beams are aligned with the three seals.
Okay, so we basically need to get those energy beams just to get them projected just to open this special potion. Okay, I'm actually going to switch to Trigger Happy so we can move things a little faster, but unfortunately, he is not a very powerful one, and I probably should have switched to Double Trouble, and yeah, that really sucks. Oh, wow. It just only guns actually gets rid of some enemies. Now, if you go to this direction, it will basically give you a story scroll. Wait, there's no... That's odd, I thought there'll be a story scroll here. Okay, oh Jesus. Alright, switching to double trouble. Use my magic beams to kill everybody. Alright, wombo combo and it ain't Falco. Come on. Oh, okay. I thought I wasn't moving for a minute. What am I? I am not using my Australian accent that much because wait, why did my crystals not... Oh, now it's green. I don't know what happened. I thought my crystals weren't green for a moment. Okay, so moving on. Is this where the scroll is? I don't honestly know. Wait, hang on. I'm a little nervous because I really don't know what to expect. I'm guessing that might be a maze. Just hang on a moment. Oh, apparently I have to go to that direction because the gate needs a key. I actually kind of forgot. So I guess I have to do the maze. And that's really gonna suck, so I'll be right back once I reach that teleporter. All areas found. So we've got one achievement. And I'm actually gonna keep Skylander as is, even though he's very slow and I, well, honestly hate it. So we're going to move the blocks from here. And let's see if I can move this crystal. Wait, can I not move it? Did I fail already? Oh no, did I? Did I fail this maze already? Oh no, that's not gonna be good. Hold on. I think I might have a strategy here. We move this. And we move this. That's how we do it. That's how we open the maze. Okay, so we got one down and only three to go. Now let's go in this chain slide. Go down the slide. Whee! And it's almost like he's skating. That's where the story scroll is. I must be, maybe it's a different, version, I guess, that I was watching. I didn't actually know the scroll was supposed to be here. And I think it's actually impossible to miss if you didn't actually, you know, skip it. Push it! Alright, so we got one down. This is gonna take a while to get all this lined up. Push it once, and we push it twice. Okay, so we open the next gate, and we've actually got another beam lined up. So all we need is one left. Slide down the chain, and I really hope there's no enemies here. And I was right, there's no enemies here. Now, we're going to move this crystal once, and we're going to push a few of those crystals, like, lined up here. Yeah, this is actually a little bit difficult if you're doing a time trial one, which is basically the time limit challenge. And, of course, we need to push this... Okay, this... How am I gonna figure this out, honestly? Hang on. I can't rotate this. So basically that block is really annoying. Oh, never mind, I can push this. That's basically it. I kind of forgot. Okay, so now we've actually unlocked the quick vault. Or the silver vault, whatever it is. But I think it's actually important for the Core of Light.
You may at last retrieve what you seek.
Oops, why did I push that? Anyway, we're gonna go to this teleporter and eat this cheese, which I'm probably gonna guess Prison Break is not a cheese fan. But same thing with me, I'm really not much of a cheese fan, to be honest, because I don't know why I didn't like cheese that much. Maybe it's because I'm not really used to having it. Oh no. Okay, come on. Yeah, these guys are really, really annoying. Just get out of the way so we don't explode. So we level up just to get one down. We get rid of him. And that's basically it. I'm not gonna upgrade the Skylanders fully because I want to do it on the Wii U version, which I'm... Oh no, not the Wii U. I mean, I'm actually going to upgrade all the Skylanders on the Wii console because that's the system I'm most familiar with. Even though I can't record games on the original Wii system, and it really sucks. Ow, 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 ow. Get lost. Yeah, these guys... They're sometimes annoying, but they're not the worst enemies. They do give you a lot of experience points. But I will actually say, they are a hell of a lot better than just giant spiders. I hate the giant spiders. They are the worst enemies in the world. And that's basically it. Uh-oh, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out. And we basically moved, or basically moonwalked while we jumped up. Okay, Oki and Ultron, do your thing. Yeah, let's see if I can go behind it. Fire. Okay, watch out, watch out. Yeah, it will still use its rockets, but after it dies. Yeah, I'm still trying to get used to the befores and afters. It sometimes gets annoying. Anyway, we have unlocked the Quicksilver. That's what it's called.
The Quicksilver.
Okay, so we basically got all enemies done. We got all areas found, we got all the collectibles, and the only thing I have to do off camera is the time limit. And that's going to be a little bit tough, because the maze one, I really, really don't know how to do it that extremely quick. Oh wow, we actually have this thing glowing symbols. That's actually... very unique. I don't know if it's the right term of unique, but at least it does one thing, which is glowing symbols.
The Quicksilver is flowing through the core. I can't believe it. Who knew that there are still remnants of the Archaeans?
We did.
Oh, well, of course you did. please. We must find the Eternal Magic Source. It's the final source we need to rebuild the Core of Light. Can you help us?
Yes, we can.
Well, they don't actually move much, but they can actually at least teleport throughout the chapters. I actually kind of forgot that during the two chapters with the Weapons Master, he will actually teleport like around the chapters. I didn't actually bring it up because I actually kind of forgot.
Of our civilization, of our power. Would you like to go to our armory now, Skylander?
Not right now because yeah, it is a little too much, but. At least we have a bit more time just to do one more heroic challenge, and I think I might have enough money just to upgrade Prison Break, which I think has given him some... I really don't know what's the last upgrade he's going to get, but I really hope it's going to be really powerful. Get up the stairs! Okay, Persephone, let's see what upgrades you have for this guy. Okay, so we got, yep, splitting energy beams, that's one. So we basically do this, and there we go. Yeah, sometimes it's actually a little difficult just to have it accurate. So we can either have energy beams or we can have crystals. Let's go for crystals, because I think the energy beam is already powerful enough. We're gonna use crystals instead. Massive energy eruption. No, why did I say energy? Massive crystal eruption. So it damages and covers a large area. Let's give this one a try. Whoa! That is very, very cool. It gives you a lot more crystals, and it's a longer range. So summon 3 crystal shards. Like, 3 of them at a time. Oops, wrong button. Whoa! So I don't have to basically go automatic. Now, check this out. Noah can get through my secret lock. Yeah, basically in movies, when you have people that have lasers as a security thing, if they touch the lasers, then there will be alarms just to get the burglar or something. I could actually use that for my bedroom, but it is very, very expensive, and I really don't think it will work in my bedroom. Okay. Oh, no. I actually forgot. The Prison Break one has giant spiders. I really don't like that one. I'm gonna try Trigger Happy and try someone else's heroic challenge. Yeah, I'm gonna give Trigger Happy the one thing. Yeah, this is the one I think is the worst heroic challenge. Basically, you have to destroy about 55 chompies, but you have to avoid the purple ones. You're only allowed to get two. So I'm gonna use my projectile attacks for this. If you have a Skylander that is overpowered, you might want to reset Skylander. So we're gonna start with 9. Okay, my heart is pounding because this is actually the worst heroic challenge, like, ever made. I think on the Xbox and PlayStation version. Oh crap! I destroyed one of them. The endangered purple chompies. If you hit another one, they'll become extinct. Don't hit another. Yeah, my heart is really pounding because I really don't want to fail this challenge. Yeah, this is why I think this is the worst one yet. And please don't level up. Please don't level up. Please don't level up. So we basically get 9 to begin with, and let's go this direction. This is gonna take a while, and I don't want to fail this now because I don't want to lose this challenge.
Almost made it.
Okay, move. Almost did it. Yeah, if you have a Skylander that's overpowered, reset the Skylander and start from scratch, but don't upgrade it or level up too early. Okay, we need 2 more. I'm so scared right now because I don't want to fail this one. Alright, come on. Yeah, I think 100 chompies is too much on the PlayStation version, but I'm glad that I got the Wii version later on. There we go! In one attempt! And I did not upgrade the Skylander fully. That is a very, very tough challenge, and I will actually say it. But it does give you 8 extra like speed, which is very, very useful.
I'm impressed, and I don't say that often.
Yeah, no, I'm not playing another one because I've done the hardest heroic challenge out there. Yeah, if you want to get all the heroic challenges for all the Skylanders, I would suggest you do the Chompy one after resetting the Skylander fully. Yeah, that is basically my suggestion. Even though it's hard for me to say it, but it is actually worth it. Next time on Skylander Sparse Adventure, we're going to do Chapter 22? Hold on, let's double check, because I think I might have forgot, really. Okay, so I have to do this one again. We're up to Chapter 21, which is to get the internal magic source. See you guys next time when we do the last 2 episodes in the main chapters, because there will be 4 special chapters in this game, and I will actually do them. See you guys next time.